So, how would it feel to initiate a conversation with anyone without having anxiety? Imagine if you could do whatever you want and still make people intrigued by you. Well, if that would interest you, I've got great news today, because in this video, I'm going over how to start and hold a conversation. My name is Junaid from Many Influencer, and I'm here to help you reach full potential. So if you want to go from a no one to a someone, then consider to join the Many Influencer community today by hitting that subscribe button and ticking that bell icon right now. Okay, so without any further ado, let's jump straight into the video. Number one, shyness. Nowadays, we live in a world full of zombies. Everyone is on their phone. This has simply caused us to be less social, and therefore we have less social interactions. So we really don't know how to start and hold a conversation. And to make it even worse, everyone is busy nowadays being on their phone, which obviously makes it even harder to initiate the first step, because now you have to put in more effort to get someone's attention because everyone is on their phone while you don't even have the experience because we have less social interactions. Okay, so how do you actually overcome your shyness? It starts with setting up your intention. Before you approach someone, know what your goal is. Do you want to make a new friend, or want to get a new client? Whatever it is, be clear about it. However, this brings a new problem. You'll start overthinking of all the scenarios that could happen in your mind. To prevent this, have a clear vision of what you want to get out of it, but focus on the now. Otherwise, you'll just get messy in your head and nothing will happen. Who can relate? Let me know in the comments down below. Number two, approach with an open body language. Okay, so every time when someone wants to approach someone else, they always think, what am I supposed to say? But research shows that the first impression actually doesn't happen when you actually hear someone, but actually when you see someone. So focus on your body language rather than actually what you're going to say. Start by setting yourself up for a nice and open body language. The first thing you should focus on are probably your hands. Studies have actually shown when you have visible hands, people find you more trustful. Another thing you should focus on are your shoulders. Have them down and back. This will actually make you more relaxed. And your so-called magical opening line, it's your smile. Because if you smile at someone, it warms them up. And obviously, if you see someone smiling, having an open body language and having eye contact, you'll probably think that person is about to talk to you. So obviously, if you see that someone's about to talk to you, you're probably gonna put your attention towards them rather than your phone. And that's how you grab their attention. Number three, openers. Okay, so now you actually know how to overcome shyness and what is actually more important than the first opening line. However, both of us know that you eventually have to say something, because smiling and actually having eye contact with someone is not gonna do it. So what should you actually say? You're a smart person that's watching this video. I knew you were going to ask that. Since you're so engaged, might as well hit that like button. And by the way, I highly recommend you guys to actually take notes, because this is some valuable content. Anyways, so research has actually shown that the best way to actually open a conversation is open body language. Okay, but for real, studies have shown that the best opening line is actually, hey, how are you? I know it's so simple, but at that case study, it showed to be the best one by far. The second and the third one were compliments. So if you don't like the first one, you might want to give a compliment to that person. Number four, hold a conversation. Everyone thinks they're amazing and always want to talk about themselves. So the obvious thing you should do is not talk about yourself, but talk about them. I know there's probably going to be a few people watching this video thinking, yeah, I don't care about them. I only care about myself. And to those people, if your ego is so high, why are you watching this video? And to those people, before you actually leave this video, hear me out. Talking about them rather than yourself is usually the case only at the start of a conversation. Because think about this, you actually had time to plan this out while the other person got approached out of the blue. So by you taking the lead and asking them a question, you only make it easier for them to invest their time in you. Eventually, they'll ask you questions back as well. Because humans find it unnatural if the conversation is 90% about them and only 10% about someone else, even though they like to talk about themselves. So in the short run, they don't mind to talk about themselves, but in the long run, it just feels weird. So later down the conversation, they'll probably try to keep it 50-50. However, you should probably try to keep it 70% about them and only 30% about yourself, because this keeps them interested and you also appear more mysterious. Number five. End it on a high note. This is one part that most people actually underestimate. Most conversations eventually get a natural ending. However, try not to push this boundary, because you will come across as unnatural and really desperate. So to actually prevent coming across as desperate, you shouldn't even let it come to the natural ending. So the best thing you can probably do to actually prevent that is try to actually end the conversation when a person is at their peak of emotional investment. Because if you end it at that point, people will get really confused and actually be more intrigued. And the coolest part about this is that the next time they see you, they'll get the same emotional feelings as when you ended the conversation. So if they are at the peak of their emotional investment and they're really happy, the next time they're gonna see you, they'll instantly be more happy. So if that isn't awesome, I don't even know what is. I hope you found this video valuable. Come on, I know you did. So if you'd like to see more videos like this, consider to hit that subscribe button and help your brother out. That's it for me. I'll see you on my next video.